नमस्ते गुरुकुलियन, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फिट एंड फाइन एट योर होम। सो टुडे अगेन वी आर हेयर विद पार्ट 6। इट इज़ चैप्टर 3, फिजिकल एजुकेशन, फिटनेस, वेलनेस एंड लाइफस्टाइल। इट इज़ ऑफ क्लास प्लस 1। इन प्रीवियस पार्ट वी कंप्लीटेड अबाउट द फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी। व्हाट इज़ फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी? यू नो रेंज ऑफ मूवमेंट ऑफ द जॉइंट इज कॉल्ड फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी। एंड there are two type of flexibility, that is active or passive. Active we are doing with ourself own body strength, or passive we are doing with external help, mean with a partner. Or active flexibility having a two part, that is active static or dynamic. Static known as without movement, or dynamic known as the with movement. Okay, static and dynamic. So today we are here to do coordinative ability. Before some time in physical education and sports, or in the sense of sports training, it is known as the agility, but nowadays we consider it as coordinative ability. Coordinative, here a indication of combination with movement. With movement plus our muscular system and nervous system. Totally involved in coordinative ability, because coordinative ability, there is a work of muscular system, or muscular system will do work with the help of nervous system. If nerve impulse go properly toward the muscular system after the observation from outside, which type of movement is demanding from outside, our body is responding according to that. So it is known as the coordinative ability. Okay, if I talk about in movement, when in which position we will tell a movement that is sharp and shine, we can say accurate movement, that is where we will found accuracy, sharpness, both are same, dexterity, accuracy, sharpness, dexterity, rhythm. If these all things are there, even combination. Combination, then we can say that movement is the according to the demand. If accuracy is there, sharpness is there, dexterity is there, rhythm is there, combination is there. Okay, one or two more thing like balance, or these all thing become in further types of coordinative ability. These all things, if we mix up all these thing in a movement, then we can say that is the coordinative ability. Even reaction ability also under the coordinative ability. So coordinative ability, you know, when we are playing a game, on that time lots of movements we have to do through our muscle, through our body. If that movement is looking sharp or accurate, any observer can observe easily. Even those person are not involving in the sports activity, they can also observe because they know the difference of the beginner or a professional player, a person who is not involving in the activity, or a person who is professionally doing the activity. Like we can say cricket. In India, lots of people are watching cricket on TV. So when they are watching a beginner to playing a cricket, easily they can observe that coordinative ability are very dull in comparison to the any cricket player like Virat Kohli or other games also. Like in cricket, throwing a throw, bowling, some are don't know the action of bowling. So these all movements relating to the coordinative ability, not only in cricket, handball, football. In football also, that you know, football is a complex game. Complex in the sense like we have to control the ball, not with our arms, with our feet. The distance of our feet is much from our brain. So we have to control the ball with our feet, with our legs. So that is very complex. Second one thing we can say, in hockey, we have to control the ball not only with our hand. At first, we have to control the stick with our hand, or with that stick, we have to control the ball. So we can predict how much coordination is required in hockey also. Very complex, very complex. Okay. So these all are known as the coordinative ability. Now we will do type of coordinative ability. Type. Types of coordinative ability. Different types are given in different books. In some books you will find 5 type, in some you will find found 7 type. We will do 7 type. Okay. So first type is combinatory ability. Second is adaptive ability. Third one is orientation ability. Fourth one is balance ability. Fifth one is rhythmic ability. Sixth one, reaction ability. Seventh one, differentiation ability. So these are the 7 type of coordinative ability: combinatory ability, adaptive ability, orientation ability, balance ability, rhythmic ability, reaction ability, or differentiation ability. So first one is the combinatory ability. Combinatory, the word combinatory, combination, it is came from the combination. You know, if I talk about a gymnastic, suppose I am doing a dips, so it is a one type of movement, but lots of that group of muscles are involving in the dips. Look, arms muscles, chest or back muscle, even some strength is there of core or legs also. But if I talk about the gymnastic, in gymnastic a athlete have to do lots of activity. That is the combination of the activity. Even in combat sports, if I talk about a boxer, not only doing like this, he have to do lots of combination of the activity, even his sudden moves to prevent himself from the opponent. So it is the type of combinatory ability. We can give the example of gymnastic. Boxing, even sometime in team games also. You know, without combination we cannot win the match. If we are playing a match, we are involving in a team game match like volleyball, basketball, even in cricket, lots of games are there. If there is a combination of all the players, combination is very good. So automatically their movements, their ability, their activity looking very good comparison to the another one if another team don't have the good combination with each other. Okay, gymnastic, boxing or team games. In gymnastic, lots of activities are there. If we combine the full activity, means running one step, that is the known as the cycle, we can say step. But if we talk about the one round of the track, so it is the, that we can say, combinatory ability. In gymnastic, boxing, team game, many more games are there. Second one is the adaptive ability. Suppose one beginner come on ground, at first he will do wrong, but if he have a sharp mind, if he have a good interest, easily he can learn the things properly of any game, not only on volleyball, basketball or other games also. Only that we can say nature difficulty of the game depend that like if I talk about hockey, then maybe duration may be much longer than volleyball, basketball or handball. But in volleyball also the complex game it is, because we have to control the ball with our arms, service is there, we have to give the pass to the setter, accuracy must be required on that time. So it is also complex comparison to handball or basketball. But if I talk about the basketball, the basketball is complex where inside the D. Okay. Adapt the activity properly or in less time. That is known as the adaptive ability. It is related to our nervous system also. Even some theories are also like play theory given by Thorndike, law of learning also, law of use, disuse, law of interest, law of that about result also. If results are not good, automatically that interest decrease. So that is known as the adaptive ability. Orientation ability, a athlete have to perform the activity according to the situation. Suppose a cricketer hit the ball and the ball is in the air, the person who have to catch the ball, at first he have to take proper position on the place where the prediction is there, ball will come on that place downward. At first he have to take proper position, or even when he have to catch the ball, everything he have to observe, that is gravity, even the action of catching, he will not hit the ball like this, he have to catch the ball with the downward facing of the hand, like his hand will go with the ball downward. Science works over there, gravity. If I talk about an athlete or in other games, if wind is blowing, so according to the situation we have to take position. Okay, so like gravity, even surface of the ground, if wind is blowing, so according to these situation we have to take position, we have to perform our movement. That is known as the orientation ability. ओके, परफॉर्म मूवमेंट अकॉर्डिंग टू ग्रेविटी, विंड ब्लोइंग एंड नेचर और मूवमेंट ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट, ओके, विद विच इक्विपमेंट वी आर प्लेइंग, अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट ऑल्सो वी हैव टू परफॉर्म द एक्टिविटी दैट इज नोन एज द ओरिएंटेशन एबिलिटी. इट इज ऑल्सो रिलेटिंग विद द कोऑर्डिनेटिव एबिलिटी, बैलेंस एबिलिटी. एज यू नो, टू मेंटेन द बॉडी इन ए पोस्चर, सम सिंपल एक्सरसाइज आर देयर और मैनी कॉम्प्लेक्स एक्सरसाइज ऑल्सो देयर. हेयर वी कैन टेक द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ जिमनास्टिक. इन जिमनास्टिक मैनी एक्टिविटीज आर देयर वेयर बैलेंस इज रिक्वायर. दे हैव टू वॉक ऑन ए वी कैन से मार्बल रोड. इवन समटाइम वट हैपन वेन वी आर गोइंग इन द फेयर्स मेले, तो लॉट्स ऑफ पीपल आर परफॉर्मिंग डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ एक्टिविटी, बैलेंसिंग एक्टिविटी, लाइक दे आर वॉकिंग ऑन ए रोप. सो वेयर वट इज डिमांड फ्रॉम आउटसाइड, दैट इज नोन एज द बैलेंस. बैलेंस नॉट ओनली इन जिमनास्टिक, इवन इन वेट ट्रेनिंग बैलेंस रिक्वायर इन जिमनास्टिक वेट ट्रेनिंग ड्यूरिंग रिदमिक एक्टिविटी ऑल्सो और अदर गेम्स ऑल्सो वेयर बैलेंस इज रिक्वायर. रिदमिक एक्टिविटी लाइक द मूवमेंट, द इनिशियल स्टेज ऑफ द मूवमेंट वी आर परफॉर्मिंग. सपोज आई एम डूइंग अ बॉलिंग, माई एक्शन, वट इज द एक्शन ऑफ माई रन अप, वट इज द एक्शन ऑफ थ्रोइंग द बॉल, मीन इनिशियल स्टेज ऑफ द एक्शन और एग्जीक्यूशन स्टेज ऑफ द एक्शन और मूवमेंट, इट शुड बी वेरी शार्प और वेरी एक्यूरेट. इट शुड बी इन द रिदम. वट इज द नेचर ऑफ एक्सरसाइज, अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट इट शुड बी देयर. You know that if we talk about when a individual doing running, we can easily compare that beginner or a professional athlete. The action of professional athlete will be very fine, will be very sharp, rhythmic, in rhythm, like one knee up, one hand up. Even those are the beginner, even they don't know the action, where the position of where he have to do the position of his arms. So rhythm. Initial position to execution of movement must be in rhythm. Even rhythmic activity not only about the movement. If we talk about the gymnastic, in gymnastic you know that one a type of that gymnastic exercise they have to perform on music. They have to listen the music from outside or they have to perform according to that beats. That beat they have to catch or according to that beat particular movement they have to perform. That is also known as the rhythmic ability. Reaction ability. Reaction ability, every game, each and every game where reaction ability require. If I talk about athletics, all the starts depend on the reaction. If reaction time is good, reaction time good means less timing a individual taking during its reaction. Suppose on that gunshot, on clapper, if reaction time is less, it means the athlete having a good reaction time, good reaction ability. In basketball, according to the opponent, a person or a player have to respond that reaction. Even the starting of the match, when that referee or umpire blow a whistle, throw that pass, immediate reaction. Okay, that is known as the reaction ability. Or even in science you read about the reaction ability, when we touch a hot surface or any sharp object, pinch our skin, that automatically our hand come back. That message to our hand, that hand goes on a that hot object, we can say. So the order go to our hand muscles, it go from the vertebral column. After the reaction, our brain know that your hand goes to the hot object or on any other sharp thing. Second one, reaction ability, we can say when we are walking, that is also part of reaction. Maybe you are not study somewhere, anywhere. When we are walking, our brain not giving the order to our hands that you have also move. Automatically it is a combination with our legs, that when right feet come forward, automatically that right hand go back or left hand come forward. That is the action. Nobody giving to the order to our arms that you have to do work. Even when we start doing running, during running, no order is there from brain that your hand automatically come here, or we start moving our arms like this. So these all are the reaction ability. Differentiation ability. Differentiation related to the higher level of accuracy. Higher level of accuracy means apex level of the movement, where we cannot find a single mistake in the movement, in the rhythm of the movement, in the, we can say, sharpness of the movement, in the balance of the movement. Everything will be fine in the differentiation ability. So these two, reaction ability, that reaction on the respond from the referee whistle or clapper or gunshot, for example we can take it, or differentiation, that sharpness of the movement, mean apex level of the good movement, known as the differentiation ability. So for today, this much. We'll see you in the next video. In next part, we will do the component of wellness, or in another part we will do physical fitness components. Okay, then this chapter will over. Tab tak ke liye sabhi ko namaste.